Successful export to North America. Selection of switch disconnectors and main disconnect switches according NFPA79. My name is Dirk Meyer, Solution Architect in the Innovation and MOEM Solution Center EMEA. For the right selection of switches, we have to remember two important terms from the part one of this seminar. It is very important to differ between feeder circuits and branch circuits. Please remember, branch circuits are circuits behind the branch circuit protective device. In these circuits, small creepage and clearance distances are allowed. In feeder circuits, devices with larger creepage and clearance distances must be used. With a differentiation between branch circuit and feeder circuit, you will find the right switch for the right place. In feeder circuits, UL489 inverse time circuit breakers, UL98 enclosed and dead front switches, or UL489 molded case switches can be used. Switches with small creepage and clearance distances, like UL508 industrial control equipment, manual motor controllers, can only be used in the branch circuit. Most all rotary switches, like the T and P switches, are usable for motor branches and control circuits. Also, the certified versions are mostly usable in the branch circuits, behind a branch circuit protective device. Only the P330MCS molded case switch were approved with increased creepage and clearance distances according UL489. Only this variant can be used as a main switch as well, in the feeder area, in power circuit branches and feeders. All rotary switches need upstream short circuit protective devices. One application for a rotary switch in the branch circuit is the use as mono disconnect. For this application, rotary switches are certified as a mono disconnect switch. For use in feeder circuits, for example as a main switch, only one version of the rotary switch is certified according UL489 as a molded case switch, the P330MCS with larger creepage and clearance distances according UL489. Another possibility for a switch in the feeder circuit are UL98 switch disconnectors. Our non-fused disconnect switch R9 have approval according UL98 and can be used as a main switch up to 600 volts. Upstream fuses for protection are required. IEC-based switch disconnectors must be tested with the unfavorable fuses according UL and CSA to get the approvals. These so-called umbrella fuses have the highest let-through energy and let-through currents. In this case, IEC-based switch disconnectors have low short-circuit values or must be oversized a lot. To solve this problem, we have introduced the so-called American UL489 molded case switches. These are switches with integrated, fixed, setted short circuit releases for self-protection. The built-in short circuit release inside the molded case switches NS are only usable for self-protection of the switch. The protection of the system behind the molded case switches must be made by external set of fuses. Inside the NFPA79, there are clear requirements for main switches. The handle of a main switch should always be connected with the switch even when the panel door is open, and the panel door must be interlocked if the switch is on. One possibility to fulfill these requirements is the use of the typical North American side-mounted handle, where a Bowden cable operator is always be connected with the switch itself. But door coupling handles are possible as well. Our special NA versions of the door coupling handles have an included door interlocking. The door is interlocked in on, in tripped, and in the off position. And to enter the cabinet, you have to turn the handle to the reset position. Then you can open the door. A small screw can be used to open the door in every position of the switch. This defeat device or defeat mechanism is allowed. An interlock system must prevent the voltage from being switched on again while the panel door is open, apart from when the interlock is overridden by a deliberate action by qualified personnel. When the door is open, the switch position of the main switch must clearly be indicated. When the main switch is switched on, a mechanical or electrical door interlocking is required. Also, this door interlocking can be overridden by qualified personnel. Here you see our solution to fulfill all these requirements with a rotary operator and a door coupling handle. There are two operators on the system, one rotary handle outside of the panel door and one rotary handle on the axis directly on the switch. So the operator is always be connected with the switch. In this version, the door interlocking is made with the outside handle. To switch on the main switch, if the panel door is open, can only be made by a deliberate action. You have to push and turn the additional handle on the switch to switch on again. This so-called deliberate action is necessary. Another possibility is to use the so-called sidewall drive. In this version, the side handle is always be connected with a switch. It can be also operated when the panel door is open, but in this case, there is no possibility for a mechanical door interlocking. The door interlocking must be made by an electric interlock switch. Also, the use of the rear operator fulfills the requirements. In this case, the handle is always be connected with the switch, but also with this version, you need an electrical door interlocking because there's no possibility for a mechanical door interlocking. What are the main switch requirements from the NFPA79? Main switches must have a means of actuation and one on and one off position. A changeover switch is not possible. A tripped position is allowed. The switch does not have to be actuated through the panel door if a different type of actuation is provided, like a motor operator. The main switch must be lockable in the off position. A manual or remote actuation must, in this case, not longer be possible. And more than in ISC, a main switch must be operable by qualified personnel without any additional parts and lockable, irrespective of the position of the panel door. The switch should be lockable outside and inside. Which devices are allowed to use as a main switch according NFPA 79? A listed switch disconnector can be used. A listed circuit breaker can be used. A listed switch disconnector with short circuit protection, a so-called moded case switch, can be used. A circuit breaker without overload release can be used if this is a part of a listed motor starter combination. Or for small machines, also a listed type E motor starter can be used for a single motor application. For very small machines, smaller than 2 horsepower, also plug and socket can be used for disconnection. If a control panel has more than one feeder voltages, every feeder voltage must have their own main switch, and a warning label must be placed on these switches. Caution: risk of electric shock. More than one disconnect switch may be required to de-energize the equipment before serving. Thank you for your attention. More informations like white papers and videos you will find on our internet site, www.eaton.eu/export.